At the time of this writing, news has just been released about the erasure of adult content off OnlyFans. Now, you have many women who have become dependent on this platform for their income, trading in the harsh hustle and bustle of realities of life for the glamorous life of sex work. With the OnlyFans founders looking to make a change, pursuing greener pastures and high-profile celebrities among others, the loyal base that raised their profit margins in a pandemic may find themselves out of work. Now, this is a common consequence when your livelihood is gambled on the ever-changing landscape of someone else's social media technology. And in web design, we call that making your stake on someone else's real estate. However, OnlyFans is not the only culprit. The same holds true for those that are on YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, etc. I prefer YouTube as my choice of majority content consumption. However, it is supplement to my primary skill set, that is web design and development, allowing me to market services and help people through the demonstration of my skills. I have not tried to pursue becoming a personality on YouTube because, let's be honest, my own camera self is still drier than a thirsty vagabond in the Sahara. So I think about others and how to serve their needs through tutorials, advice, and exposés, video types that usually do not require my face on camera. So, what are some of the skills, more specifically in web design and development and other things that I'm doing that will pay the bills? Creating video content, building websites, configuring emails, and constructing articles have blessed me with these abilities. HTML5, CSS, JavaScript, WordPress development, video editing, writing, and just a general understanding of configuring streaming platforms such as Vimeo OTT. Now, as a public school teacher, there is this type of learning called project-based learning. What this simply is learning skills through a given project that is being worked on at the moment. In web design, this type of learning is ideal, as with building every website and application comes a new set of traits acquired on top of your base. When I left my purist perspective of hand coding, accepting WordPress projects, that introduced to me even new challenges which elevated my career. Once I actually pressed through those challenges. Welcoming such work allowed me to easily assist other people's visions, paying it forward and opening doors, future doors for myself. Therefore, I earn a living on the strength of my abilities. Now, it's ironic how we think we're living the employee-free lifestyle when in reality we have traded one perceived abusive boss, that being corporate America, for an attractive spouse who you know for certain won't commit to you. And that is the platform such as YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, Instagram, etc., Facebook, all that. If you are fortunate enough to have made it as a full-time content creator, congratulations. My hats go off to you. But you must realize that you're still living on borrowed time, and that time has been expedited for you. All it takes is one wrong move, and you're excused off the site for violating some obscure policy. Then you'll probably be back in a position having to crawl back to the corporate underworld, which will probably cause you to have a panic attack or a nervous breakdown. Now, the worst part is, if you are a quote-unquote YouTuber, TikToker, Instagrammer, whatever the case may be, you do not realize that your livelihood is probably even more jeopardy than you actually work in a standard, traditional, 9-to-5 place of employment, that being in whether in retail, whether in office space, wherever the case may be. At least with those places, there is some form of a binding contract. And I know the argument's going to be that where those places could let you go at the drop of a dime anytime that they want to. Now, that may very well be true, but at least you have a higher chance of being protected by some sort of legal backing. When you're on YouTube and you're on Twitch and all these things, these platforms are free. They owe you nothing. So the fact that you think that you're entitled, you're indebted to some form of employment protection where you're really not an employee for them, you're considered more so of an independent contractor, and they just present to you, if you fulfill these requirements, you get these perks, and at any given moment, you could lose those perks within the snap of a finger the minute that you say something out of line or your content and doesn't align with them, and we already know that the algorithm is already having those problems, then that means that your livelihood is just, it's at a higher gamble, it's at a higher risk than it would be at a regular job. The thought of having to serve somebody else will make creators melt worse than the Wicked Witch of the West. That is the water being thrown on their own self-serving intentions. Yet again, irony rears its ugly head. People desiring an entrepreneur fantasy will not mind having employees of their own, whether outsourced or overseas, or for hire locally, to serve their goals and missions. So in conclusion, developing skills and a selfless mentality is critical not only for our survival, but the societal development as a whole. I mean, let's be honest, you can't innovate and further advance society through cat video productions or dancing on TikTok videos alone.